Thanks for joining us for another Genie Aerial Pros Minute. My name is Mike Flanagan, Product Manager at Genie. Today we're going to talk about aerial work platforms, and specifically loading and unloading from pickup trucks. Genie Aerial Work Platforms, or AWPs for short, are part of a family of portable personnel lifts. One-person lifts that are push around, fairly lightweight, and allow operators to get up and do some light-duty construction, light-duty contractor work, such as electrical work, facilities maintenance, maybe some painting, and don't require the logistics of transporting a self-propelled machine with a trailer or a big tractor trailer, for example. So when you're looking at an aerial work platform, it's really designed for logistics, really designed for transportability. So one thing we want to make sure is that we're following the instructions in the operator's manual for loading and unloading, because it does require some light lifting. So when you're done working with your aerial work platform, first we want to make sure that the platform is fully lowered in the stowed position. We want to make sure the emergency stop is off, the key switch is off, and the key has been removed from the machine. Additionally, we want to make sure the outriggers are removed from the outrigger pockets, and they're going to be stowed in the outrigger storage compartment, which on this machine would be on the other side of the mast. Finally, for DC or battery-powered machines, we want to make sure that the battery is taken off of the back of the machine and placed in a position, whether it's in the truck or outside of the truck for now. For transport, we want to make sure it's properly tied down, because it is a liquid battery. On the back of the machine, you'll find a few pieces that are critical for loading and unloading from a pickup truck. One of which is called the loading stop bracket, and we also have what's called the loading pivot bar. So when we have our pickup truck in place, ideally on a firm, level surface, in park with the parking brake on, we can back our AWP up pretty close to the tailgate, because what we're going to do is we're going to look at the tailgate and we're going to set the position of the stop bracket and the pivot bar such that the pivot bar is as close to the tailgate as possible. Once we've locked the stop gate in position with the pins, we're going to raise the pivot bar, which will be resting down here. We're going to raise the pivot bar and latch it into the stop bracket. Once we've got the pivot bar secured up at the tailgate height position, we can back up the machine until the pivot bar is resting firmly on the tailgate. Once we've got it set up and ready to go, we have a sliding T-handle that is underneath the platform in the front of the machine. And what we can do is we'll need to pull a pin to release the handle, slide it out until that pin locks into place. Now we're ready to lift the machine into the pickup truck. Important things to remember is Genie aerial work platforms are pretty lightweight machines when compared to a slab scissor. Slab scissor is usually 2,500 pounds or more, whereas Genie aerial work platforms are anywhere from 600 to 900 pounds. So they're lightweight, but they're still not light. So we need to make sure that we're, one, using proper lifting technique, and two, using the appropriate number of people to lift the machine into the pickup truck. So once we've got the machine backed up to the pickup truck, and we'll back it up here. So we've got the pivot bar resting pretty close to the tailgate. We've got the T-handle pulled out. We're ready to pull up on the T-handle, which is going to pivot the aerial work platform onto its back around that pivot bar. Once we got the AWP pivoted 90 degrees, we're now in a position where we can push the AWP into the pickup truck's bed. And we're assisted here by a third set of wheels that you'll see on the rear of the machine, a slider block that is on the mast, and also a small set of wheels that is up near the lifting point at the top of the mast. Once we've got the AWP completely inside the pickup truck's bed, we can push it all the way to the front of the pickup's bed, and then we want to make sure that we're securing it for transport. So how do we secure it for transport? Well, first, we need to make sure that we stow the T-handle. So we can stow the T-handle by pulling the pin, slowly lowering it down, and then making sure that the pin is in and locked in the T-handle. Finally, we'll want to make sure that we use at least two chains to tie down the aerial work platform over the mast. And we can you can look into the back of the operator's manual for instructions on where do we place those tie downs to make sure the aerial work platform is appropriately secured. A couple tips for loading and unloading. One is we want to make sure that our vehicle, our pickup truck, is on a firm, level surface. Any type of incline or decline is going to make the loading or unloading not only challenging for us as we might have to push upslope, but also dangerous for when we're unloading. We also want to make sure that the parking brake of the vehicle is on to avoid any movement as we're rotating the aerial work platform up into the truck bed and as we're pushing it into the bed. Additionally, one tip is to lay down a piece of 1/2 inch to 3/4 inch plywood in the truck bed over the tailgate while the tailgate's lowered. This will provide you a nice smooth surface over what otherwise may be dented or have some gaps where the tailgate meets the main part of the truck bed. And it provides you a nice surface for the AWP to roll into, which can then be tied down. So as you can see, there's some technique required for loading and unloading an aerial work platform. You can find more information and proper instructions in the back of the aerial work platform operator's manual. And if you have any questions, you can reach out to your local Genie dealer or call your local Genie sales rep. Thanks again for watching an Aerial Pros Minute, and tune in next month for more.